Previously on building Benny's movie park.
First of all, I'm gonna start by adding some more landscape because we obviously need some more space to work with. So now I have to make this look like a mountain, just a little more. Then let's make a basic layout for the Great Hall. I now know why nobody makes roofs like this in the game. I'm just gonna get rid of the whole thing. Well, all that effort for nothing. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to yet another episode of Building Benny's Movie Park. The legs are looking fabulous today. And actually today I'm gonna start by doing two of your requests. Lukey Bobo requested to change the Dino Dessert sign into Dino Dinner, which actually makes much more sense since inside there's clearly fries and pizza and burger. So let's go and change this dinner. That's not so great. Wait a minute. There you go. Beautiful. And then someone else commented about the cave and to be exact, the crystals, which would be way better if they're yellow because then it could be amber. And in that case, it would actually fit the Jurassic Park theme way better since it's a thing. So let's go ahead and do that really quick. That has a totally different vibe, but I'm here for it. So with all that done, let's continue building Hogwarts. So a tiny little thing. Last episode, after I stopped recording, I did some experimenting with track because I did kind of like the idea I had at the end of last episode. But so I accidentally made a pretty good drop and I don't want to risk destroying it and then never getting it back the same way it is now. So I'm sorry. But I will show you what it looks like. Like the spiral drop at the beginning turned out really nice. And that's the main reason I didn't want to destroy it. So it goes up just like that. And here you go. This is a super smooth drop. Absolutely love it. And then it goes out here and then you die. This bit right here is just way too perfect. Look at that. Look at how smooth it is. So yeah, now let's continue this track. Because as long as the track isn't done, I have no idea what to build where. So yeah, let's see. After this, it's gonna go right there. Perfect. Maybe something like this. And then here it's gonna make one of these nice turns. And maybe then it just kind of goes back in. Something like that. Let's actually test it first. Let's see how this goes. First, it's gonna drop again. Whee! Oh, I like that a lot. That's actually a bit smoother than I expected. This is what I like. That's like, yeah, that's an overbank right there. But then once it gets inside, what's it gonna do then? Let's make a hole so we can see what we're doing. Then it's going right about here. I have no idea what it's gonna do. The lack of room inside of this place is honestly very annoying. It makes me wanna, I'm guessing something like this. I feel like this area here could be a little smoother. I'm just gonna try something. I have no idea if this is gonna work or not, but I have to do something. And it's gonna go in. Outside, into the block breaks, and then it goes back inside. Perfect. I don't know why it holds though. Guess who just joined? Timon0808. Timon. That's like one of these names you just can only pronounce in Dutch. Timon0808. I saw you struggle with a floorless coaster. Oh hell yes. Yes, yes, yes I was. But today it's actually going a little bit better. Okay, here we go. This is a serious test. It may actually be finished right now. But there's a big chance it won't make it at the end. Gonna go in here, onto the block breaks, and then slowly it'll hopefully return to the station in one piece. No, no, it will not. It will? Oh, although I don't like this area at the back, so I don't think I'm actually gonna keep that. But let's first make this hole here because this is horrible. Holeable. Oh, no, that doesn't work. I feel like this is a little smoother towards the end here. Let's see how that goes. See, that is a lot better. That's a lot better. Let's start with making the wall a little higher because obviously this has to become the Great Hall and right now it is not so great. But then the question is, how high is it actually gonna be? Like at least this, right? See, that's a nice Great Hall. It's actually not all that great, but it's definitely not gonna fit four rows of tables in it either. But it's the thought that counts. Last one. There you go. Beautiful. Voice crack, what the hell? Then I also kind of need to know first where people are gonna enter. How the heck are people gonna get up there? That's something I should have thought about a little sooner. How about right up here? We make a little flat area and then they just go right up here with a bunch of stairs, I guess. Let's just try this. Then maybe a few times around and then what? Maybe let's not do this. Instead, we'll just go straight here. And then there it goes down. Whoops, what the heck? And this is then the entrance, I guess. Or this whole opening of the tunnel is the entrance. That's actually a pretty good idea. Anyway, I'll take care of that later because first I'm gonna work on the inside of the Great Hall. First, I'm gonna put some path on here. Then let's replace all of these with rope fences because those look way better. And also they match the theme way more. And we can also make that sort of stage. Is it a stage? I should probably do it this way instead. And just like that, I can make those stairs very narrow, which is exactly what I'm aiming for. And paint all of that freaking beautiful. I know what you're thinking. This isn't gonna look great, but just trust me, it is. As I said, not four rows, just two, because four is just never gonna fit. Then I will put these on the top to make sure that's one huge tabletop. What's better, that or the other side? Actually, I don't know. For accuracy, I'll just go with this. On the back here, there's supposed to be this huge window, which I have no idea how to make. But so far, I made everything work, so I bet we could do that as well. Of course, there's also the windows, which I almost forgot about. So those we have to put somewhere here. Okay, then let's see. Then maybe if we make some black glass like that, you can see through it, but not really. I think that's actually a pretty good idea. Now the question is how much see-through. Maybe like just 10% only. Maybe this brown tint right here could be a little better. Let's paint them all. Yeah, that's definitely better. The walls in the Great Hall are actually this sort of orange, yellow-ish, tan almost color. So I'm thinking maybe this way I can do that without ruining the outside of the wall. Maybe it's actually more this color. It is so cozy in here. So many nice people. Then let's add some of these guys because that's apparently very accurate to the movie. Then these vertical thingies that the original has as well. By the way, I have this image as a reference. So just so you know, this is what I'm creating from. Let's paint those. Nice wood. Nice and warm color actually because I want the inside to be very cozy and just very nice and warm. The same vibe that the original Harry Potter Great Hall has. Then let's work on the windows for a little bit. I think like this we can make those nice vertical sort of thin windows. At least that's the idea. And then let's put a nice wedge up there to make the shape correct. Ooh, that actually is pretty cool. And then maybe a nice horizontal one as well.
Ooh.
I am liking the looks of that. Then let's do another one down here. And those are then the windows. Beautiful. Now we just have to do that on the other side as well. Also, some of these torches could make it look just a bit more interesting because in the original hall, there's these sort of angels holding those bands of fire. Obviously, I can't do that, but this is a good alternative. Then let's put the same windows in here because here there's gonna be the huge window, a very nice and pretty one. Then we need some more of these vertical poles. Of course, we also need the big table right here where all the headmasters are sitting. See that spot right there? That's a perfect spot for a door. Maybe we can put some tiny little cups on the tables. See what I did there? No, it's because I didn't do anything. Heck. Even some plates. Then let's paint all of those. Now, doesn't that look nice? Actually, I may as well do that same thing here, like with the plates and stuff. It's gonna look a little weird, but oh well. This actually looks very nice. This is amazing. Well, I guess, Frosty's doesn't have a plate. Wait a minute. There you go, mate. On the side of the hall, there's all these sort of tiny little towers. And I think this is pretty accurate. I'd actually want them to be a little smaller, but there's like zero primitives that are the right size, so that kind of sucks. Are you telling me this is the most pointy thing there is? It's not accurate. It's not actually all that pointy, but what else am I supposed to do? Now the question is, how high is the tip gonna be? I'm guessing something like this. So let's make a horizontal bar right in the middle. And then, ladies and gentlemen, I gotta make the roof just like... Wait a minute. So now all I gotta do is just kinda make sure the whole thing is covered. I have a feeling this is gonna look incredible. Now, would you take a look at that? If I look at it right now, this whole area could have been maybe one layer lower, but it's too late to change it now. But overall, I really do like the way this looks. Then again, I gotta make the same thing on the other side as well, so I'm just gonna quickly go over it. And then hopefully we can wrap up building the Great Hall today, or at least the biggest portion of it. And I guess I can try making that sort of medieval edge. I don't actually know what you call that. Something like that. That's actually pretty good. Once again, of course, based on the photo I have of Hogwarts, if that photo is actually accurate. But guys, I am pretty sure that for today I've done enough. I mean, look at all this stuff. I think this looks absolutely amazing. The top isn't really finished yet, but I guess we have more days to come. So no worries there. Also, the coaster track is completed, so I'm very happy about that. It's not super smooth, but it's definitely smooth enough. So, well, if you guys have any ideas for this whole thing, let me know down below in the comments. Do take in consideration that I'm still building all this, so there's a big chance that I'm already gonna do your idea. But just do it anyway. And then I guess that is it for today. If you like this video, make sure to leave a like and a comment. And if you enjoy my overall content, feel very, 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 very free to subscribe. And then I hope I'll see you in the next episode of Building Benny's Movie Park.